Thank you. Thank you. day there came from heaven the sound of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the house.
Playing around, we're going back.
for the monkey, Lord.
You just want to praise the Lord.
You just want to praise the Lord. This is kind of like an auctioneer tonight. You better not stand up or you'll be counted. Go ahead, Brother Bernard. Praise God.
Wow. 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 We have to go back. We have to go back. Where it's black or white. Where things stand strong. The beginning of the service, Sister Marlo sang a song. He said, "Love lifted me." Now, it's not any kind of love.
He lift me up.
I'm not just talking about, I say, I love you. Yes. We're talking about the love in the Bible.
Yes.
The fifth chapter of Galatians.
Oh God.
The sixth chapter of Galatians. Yes. That's the love that she was singing.
Yes. Yes.
That love.
Amen.
That lifted me and lifted you.
Yes.
That allowed me to lift at you when you're down.
Amen.
Church, I love you.
Amen.
It has been a long time.
Amen.
The enemy got me so low.
Amen. Oh, yes, brother.
I was so down.
Amen.
I couldn't even say hello to the church, spiritually speaking.
Bless the Lord. Bless the
Lord. But to your prayer,
bless the
my family,
yes, up on your
my prayer,
bless the
praise
Lord.
God.
And I was able to win the victory to the enemy.
Bless
yeah,
the Lord.
Don't never give up.
And I thank God for this church.
Yes, yes.
For you have never give up on me.
Yes,
you never look at me otherwise.
Yes.
You show me love.
Yes.
Oh, yes, brother.
That I can sit today and say, thank you,
church. What we're to do.
Thank you, Lord.
The message our pastor preached this afternoon. I believe we need to go back to that message.
Amen.
Because there's more to it.
Amen.
There is more to that message.
More to that message.
Do you believe that, church?
I believe that.
When I'm looking at this congregation, some of my generation may say that congregation is older.
Bless the Lord.
Right?
Amen.
I'm 44 years old. And there's many that is my age. And I'm guilty of that.
Yes.
We will say this congregation is older.
That was.
There is things this the leadership in this congregation cannot do.
That's it.
But then we have a preacher.
Yes.
We have a prophet.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
That show us
what's right to do.
What to do.
That's it.
Yes.
Amen.
To the approval of the Father.
Yes.
Amen.
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 We're going back to the 13th chapter of Joshua.
Yes.
The 13th chapter of Joshua.
Yes.
Let's see, Lord, use your Lord. Use my
verse 1. I'm going to read two scriptures in that chapter.
Yes.
Verse 1 and 13.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
The Bible says, now Joshua was old and stricken in years.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord said unto him, thou art old and stricken in years. And there remaineth yet very much land to possess.
Come on.
Did you hear that?
Hallelujah.
There remaineth yet very much land to possess. Verse 13, Brother Steve, if you please.
Yes.
Nevertheless.
Yeah. Nevertheless.
Nevertheless.
The children of Israel.
Yes.
Spell not the Jerusalemite, nor Merchantize, but the Gertrude at the Merchantize dwell among the children of Israel until this day.
My God. My God.
You see, the video that my brother sent me last night, there was a group of people were singing in that video. There was an elderly man, somewhere around in his 80s, and there was another elderly woman, probably in the late 90s. The man was playing an harmonica, and the lady was playing a bass guitar. And there was some singers among them, way younger, somewhere around my age or younger. But the intention was on the two elderlies. When I seen that, and I said, yeah, there's a message in there.
Yes.
Now, why did God tell Joshua there is yet much land to conquer?
Bless the Lord.
He knows that Joshua was 80-something years old. Is he not?
Yes, he was.
He does. But he tell him there was yet more to conquer.
There's more.
Yet more. Yet more.
There is more.
Praise God. More. Praise God.
Pastor Marlon.
Yes. Yes.
You elderly brethren.
Yes.
I want to tell you. I know we have seen that. You owe this work you can do. Uh-huh. But yet, the Bible says, there's more land to conquer.
There's more land. Yes.
There's more land.
All right.
Okay, where are those land at?
Amen.
Where are they?
Amen.
So there's work for them to do.
There's work.
There is work in them to do.
There is work.
Yes, there's footprint that me and some younger men that I have to follow.
Amen.
Off them.
Amen. Amen.
So I can't say that they can't do, so there's some work that they can't do.
There is work to be done.
There's work for them to do.
All right, brother.
Because they are preachers. They are men of God. Now, Brother Marlo said in the 10th verse this morning, the 14th chapter, he was talking, he told you what Joshua and Caleb. These two men know each other when they were little boys. The Bible tells us.
Yes.
But he said, Joshua, Caleb tell Joshua, you know me since I was a little boy. We've been in battlefield.
Yes.
Give me my land.
Let me have my mountain.
Let me have my part.
Yes. Yes.
Even though I'm 85 years old, let me have it.
Let me have the mountain.
I still can do it.
Praise God.
There's a phrase that we use, out of 85, still can have a spirit of teenagers.
Bless the Lord.
Still have a spirit of teenage young men or
yes,
young women.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yes.
At my age, this time I feel like I can run them out. So I believe when they have that spirit in them, they can do twice bigger than I can do.
Yes.
Through the help of God.
Yes, amen.
Through the help of God.
Yes, God. Yes. Praise God.
Now,
amen.
Let's go to the Father in the 13th verse. There's a word here say, nevertheless.
Nevertheless.
There's the message. Nevertheless, for you and I.
Yes.
I remember there was an English teacher told me, Americans use this word nevertheless only in defense. Uh-huh. When they want to defend something, they use nevertheless. But they never use it in offensive. Uh-huh.
That's right.
They never use it in offensive.
Yes.
You see, many of us
come on.
Have so many nevertheless in our life.
Come on.
Yes.
That we have not let go to conquer that land.
Yes.
Oh, Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
You see, our pastor said we are not preaching the wilderness message anymore.
No, 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 sir.
No, indeed.
So if we're not preaching that message, I believe nevertheless should be never in our life, in my life.
Amen.
You see, some of us
amen.
Said, brother, but now I don't smoke tobacco anymore. Brother Bernard, I don't drink anymore. Brother Bernard, I don't go to club anymore. Brother Bernard, I don't do certain things. But you still gossip. Right? Now, you can look at it different. However you say it, you may say it's just Brother Bernard talking. But I'm going to tell you. I will not, but you still gossip.
Yes.
You're still hanging out with the same crowd you were hanging out yesterday.
My God.
Nevertheless.
Nevertheless.
Nevertheless, I can deal with them. Nevertheless, I can have the same offering that will not affect my spiritual life. Nevertheless, I still can go mingle with some other friend. It will not bother me. I'll be in service Sunday morning or Saturday evening. My life will still be the same.
No.
Nevertheless.
Nevertheless.
I'm here to tell you, as a Christian,
talk about it.
There should never be any nevertheless in your life or in my life.
Amen.
If we want to take engine out of our life, Amen. Nevertheless should end.
Amen. Amen.
There is a scripture in number 33rd chapter, verse 55. I'm going to show you what the Bible says. If you still keep nevertheless in your life, what would happen? Numbers 33, verse 55 says, but if you will not drive out the inhabitant of the land that formed before you, then it shall come to pass that those which you let remain of them shall be pricks in your eyes and torn in your side and shall verse you in the land where you dwell.
Amen.
Lord, help us.
Lord, help us.
You see what happened? Those friends. I remember many years ago, there was a man of God telling me, he said, Brother Bernard, if you become a Christian and you still have the same friend, something wrong with your walk.
Yes.
Right. Amen.
He told me.
Yes, yes, yes.
But it was a time of my life I found myself alone.
You are preaching now.
I found myself alone. Because those friends was no longer there anymore.
They're not there.
Right.
That doesn't mean I didn't love them. That doesn't mean I wouldn't help them. That doesn't mean I wouldn't call them.
That's it.
But we no longer participate in the same things we were yesterday.
Amen.
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 All right?
Amen.
We no longer. Because now I found myself on a new direction. That direction is to walk according to the word of God.
Amen.
Am I perfect? No.
Amen.
But I'm doing my best to walk straight toward
the
narrow.
Hallelujah.
You see, the children of Israel were saying, these people were there. Yes, they were. This many country. I can go back to my own land in Haiti where I was born. The history says there was a slogan that the men used when they were getting take their independence from the French. It wasn't good. It wasn't pleasant. Because it was violence.
Yes.
It was violence. Does that mean I have to keep that?
My God.
I don't have to keep it.
Amen.
So whatever I have to do to get them out.
Amen.
Get it out of my life. Because if I leave it,
right.
If I leave it around me,
if you leave that,
next I'll find out doing the same thing they're doing.
Amen.
Doing the same thing that my forefather used to do. But if I push it aside, give myself a chance to walk right toward God.
Amen.
Church, I love you. The men give this message today. I believe it's our message for you and I to put in our life and encourage them.
Yes.
Encourage them.
Praise God, praise God.
As men of God.
Yes.
As men of God to do what they're doing because God still speaks to them.
God still speaks.
He still speaks.
Amen.
He's still using them.
Amen.
Still showing them.
Amen.
Still instructing them.
Amen.
You see, if I go to another city and I forget my father, or I will find myself alone.
Amen.
Because I will not have any support.
That's right.
He's still my father.
Still
this is still my church.
Right. Still your father.
You're still my brother. You're still
praise
my sister.
God,
wherever
God.
I go, there's a logo behind me that says Burlington Gospel Tabernacle. And I'm proud to carry it. I'm proud to carry that logo behind me.
Hallelujah.
I feel good walking with it. This man's out and look at me.
Amen.
A few months ago, I went down to Fort Myers with him to a minister's meeting. He probably knows what was going on.
Yes.
I didn't. But when I sat around the table and see the immigration that he was taking, there's some story that he told me, but I've never seen it until then. That evening, that day, that morning. But there is a God.
There is a God.
Because he said, whom he chose, he verified him and justified him.
Amen.
He has chosen this man of God
Amen.
To lead this place, to lead this church,
Amen.
To lead you, to lead me.
Amen.
And that's why God can speak to them. And I feel good. I feel proud to be a son of
God.
God bless you, church.
All right. All right. God for that word. That was the word. Amen. 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 That was the word. Praise God. And you know everybody's welcome at home.
Come on, Candy.
Come on, Candy. Praise God.
I'll never forget what you've done for me.
Well,
in the yet when we were what sinners, Christ died for us. I thought about that song. Do you realize that God's in his only son, only begotten, not somebody in the alley, not somebody he wanted. Oh, you can take care of them. No, he's in his very best. I have a child on the other side. And I would never want him back in this ugly world. But God sent his son knowing his death for me, for you. Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Day by day, I hope I do. My little snippets where I can actually say, oh, I didn't do wrong, or I'm doing right. You know, we're in between two, or maybe we want to do wrong, but we actually don't. I don't. And I think, God, every day I want to be less a marionette on the strings. I want to cut those strings.
Amen.
And I think about the song last time we were singing. Oh, God. I thought, boy, Sister Molly, you did a really nice job of lightening up the church. It was so beautiful, like enlightened over in that corner. I thought, you crazy bee. That's the Holy Ghost. It was just like a haze. And you did lighten it up, but it was like a haze in you last night.
Praise God.
I appreciate what God's done for me.
Oh,
I don't get up and say it very often, but I love Brandon Gospel Tabernacle. I asked the Lord when I was very young if he would allow me to find his people. And yes, I was born in a turkey yard, but I ended up in Eagle's Nest. And I appreciate it.
I want to tell you about Sister Candy. Come on, Candy. Sister Candy Sheridan. She came here when she was a teenage girl from Michigan.
Yes.
The family came here just to inquire who we were. And she was in a Bible college in Minnesota. But God spoke to her heart.
Yes.
And God spoke to that family.
Yes.
And there's her mother sitting back there now. And her mother came. The family came. There were children. But do you believe God can speak to you any age, any level?
Yes, I believe.
Isn't it wonderful when the Lord chooses you and calls you?
Yes.
Thank God the Lord kept her 40 years and more here.
Yes.
Studying, praising God.
Yes,
God is a wonder. God is a wonder. It isn't what man adds to the church.
Come on.
It's what God adds to the church.
Yes.
Praise the name of God.
Praise God. Yes.
Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Lord, bless them, bless them, bless them.
Yeah.
I can feel healing flowing out of here right now. I can feel healing. That little girl back there, cancer victim a few days ago, but she's not a victim tonight. Shannon is not a victim tonight. She's a victor tonight. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. The devil's kingdom is shaking tonight. He's coming, he's coming, he's coming. Oh, the king is coming. Praise our God. Praise our God. Don't you live in your misery. Don't you live in your past. Don't you live in your yesterday. God is with you right now. It doesn't matter what you did, what you've done. Jesus Christ and his blood is dead in the church tonight. The cross is still in the church tonight. The blood is still in the church tonight. Hallelujah. Off God isn't through to you yet. Praise our God. I expect to see you dancing down this aisle one of these nights. You're going to get out of that chair and you're going to run for Jesus again. Like you did when you were a boy. Praise God. You throttled my bicycle when you were a boy. I'm going to see that boy run again. I don't care what the doctors have told him. They told him he can't walk. They told him he can't run. But Carol, we don't believe that. I believe Jim McClintock will get out of that chair and run one night. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. I said there's no God like Jehovah.
Amen.
You young people, you found something better than the world ever could have. wherever you are in this house, whatever your name is, whatever your age is, I dare you to lift your hand right now and say, Spirit, run through me. Run through me, Holy Ghost.
I was watching a movie the other day. It's called Do You Believe?
Yes.
Do you believe in Jesus? Do you believe in the cross? Do you believe in what he died for? He died for our sins, for us to live for him, to serve him.
Yes, dear.
He didn't have to. No, he didn't have to do it. But he did it because he loved his kids. He loved us.
Yes. Turn you around, brother.
We're going to have a great week this week. Brother Jerry Manning from Kingsport, Tennessee, is a fireball, 33-year-old, zealous firebrand for God. And he's building a good church in Kingsport, a new destiny. He'll be here tomorrow afternoon. He's going to stay on the campus here. He'll be with us all week long. Service is Wednesday night. It's Monday night, tomorrow night, Monday night Bible study at 6, choir at 7:30, and then Tuesday night, the bilingual service. Brother Ferris told me, where's Brother Ferris? He's on the sound booth, on the translation booth. He said they had a tremendous bilingual service this morning.
Hallelujah.
Brother Matthew, I know you had something over the bridge.
Yes.
I have a check with you. I know you did.
Yes, sir.
Hey, listen, I know you did because there's one of the most faithful men I've ever put out on the field in pastoring and working and zealous and ready to do anything he can do to light a fire here in the home church. In the home church. But he's also a steady, faithful pastor to the Ridge Church.
Praise God.
Not only that, he doesn't just do that, but he puts his muscle and his heart behind the whole church. And I thank God for you men around me. Every one of you have your qualities. Every one of you have your gifts. And without you, the church would not be the church. Without those girls singing like Jehovah, there's no God like Jehovah. For the David Rebels, without you playing those drums back there, the church is the church. Praise God. And it's wonderful. I'm expecting, brother, he's taking a vacation. He has a told me yesterday, I was with him yesterday, he took me to the airport last night to get back here after we were in a conference in Tennessee, and he said, Brother Marlo, I just want to rest some, but I'm going to be in every one of the services I can, and if you like old time fire brand, let him go, praise God, preaching. Jared Manning is just that way. He'll be with us all week long in every one of the services at the Bridge Church Sunday morning. He'll be here Sunday afternoon. He'll be here Sunday night. He'll be here Wednesday night. He'll be in Fort Charlotte Thursday night. We'll take a load and go over to Sebring Friday night. And join the church over there. There's a fellowship church in Sebring. The pastor came out of this work right here. And they've got a great work going over there in Sebring, Highlands Christian Assembly. And God is doing a good work. Praise God. Fort Charlotte Gospel Assembly is growing down south of us. And God is working in the bridge across the river. And I say it's time to spread the gospel. Tell the people about it. Sister, I wanted LaDonna to sing that song, We're Going Back. Sang it years ago in the church. But you've been through some things since then. And we've been through some things. And the church has been through some things. But now we know more what that song means. We're going back. Before I do anything else, I wanted to read the scripture. That's what I wanted to do. Praise God. And I feel like I want to sanctify God's word. And God is so great here tonight. I'm not going to minister. I just want to read the word. I feel God is so great here tonight that I want to honor God. I've been here a long time. You know that. But I'm seeing something happen again. In this church. It's coming back. It's coming back. We had this glory visit us in the 70s and the 80s, but after many years of testing and trying and the fire burning, thank God. Heaven knows the victory is sweeter after you go through the battle. When you go through the battle and come out, isn't the victory sweeter? Don't you feel like saying, praise the Lord more? You've been through the fire. I'm telling you. place back in the middle. When they come out of the fire, they shouted like they never do. Praise God, there's no God.
No God.
In the whole lot. They could talk about it. They could talk about it. They've been in the fire. Praise God. I want to read this to hallow the word. Revelation tonight, 14th chapter. This belongs to us tonight. And I'm going to read just a two or three verses. I'm not preaching on it. I'm just going to read it. Praise God. Praise God. I want to hallow the word, sanctify the word here in our midst. But here in Revelation 14 and 1, the scripture said, And I looked.
Oh, yes.
And lo, the Lamb stood, a Lamb that is, stood on the Mount Zion.
Yeah.
And with him, 144,000, having his Father's name written in their foreheads. Not on their foreheads. Not on their foreheads. In their foreheads. Praise God, I can feel that name written here tonight. Oh, hallelujah. And I heard a voice from heaven as the voice of many waters. And I feel that voice tonight. Just rippling like a water. The waters coming down from the fountain and the falls of Niagara tonight. Praise God. And the scripture said, and I heard the voice of harpers harping. Well, I skipped part of that. And voice of many waters, and as the voice of a great thunder, and I heard the voice of harpers harping with their harps, and they sung, as it were, a new song before the throne, and before the four beasts, and the elders, and no man could learn that song but the 144,000, and 144,000, which were redeemed from the earth.
From the earth.
These are they which were not defiled with women, for they are virgins. These are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed from among men. Praise God. Having the first fruits unto God and to the Lamb. And in their mouth was found no guile, for they are without fault before the throne of God.
Amen.
I'm glad that we don't narrow that down to theological thinking like some have, that that's the total number of saved, that's the total number of those in heaven. The scripture doesn't say that at all. Doesn't say that at all. There are people that have narrowed that scripture down, taken it, and tried to make it mean that. That this is the only number that God saved. Friend, read your Bible again. Read your Bible again. The Bible tells us explicitly in the 7th chapter that he said, what are these, John? And he said, sir, thou knowest. And he said, this is the great multitude which no man, this is only a picture in Revelation 14 showing how God selects and elects even those to the highest level. But then there's thousands that no man, of thousands that no man can number among the saved and redeemed of the earth. Praise the name of Lord. In fact, it's millions upon millions.
Yes.
You think the grace of God would only cover just that number? God's grace goes far beyond that.
Amen.
God's grace goes far beyond that number. Thank God, but this is a number that is without fault. But so are the rest of them in Revelation 7, because these are they which have washed their robes in the blood of the Lamb.
They
perfected themselves by the word of their testimony. Sister Marlo, won't you have in a second? Is your voice gone? Is it gone completely? Praise God. Can you go to the left? Amen. If it's gone completely, you can't speak to me after service. Praise God. Amen. We have been married 59 years. Praise God. Praise God, praise God, praise God. This song, I'm going to dedicate it. I so enjoyed meeting so many of you today, and so many new ones are coming to help us and being with us. The missionaries, here's four of them lined up here tonight. My goodness sakes. They came because of your testimonies. Sister Gloria, your testimony. Jean, Daniel, your testimony. Reach. Look at these precious ones here. Israelites indeed. God loves you. And we love you.
Praise God.
Praise God. There's six, yes. Right in that front room. Oh, the song.
Praise God. That's the big boy.
You are a reincarnation. I'm a dear sister. Isn't that so? Isn't that so? Her name is Jean, but there was a Judy. Praise God. Right, Hank? And you are reincarnation. Praise God.
Oh, Pastor, because the love never ends.
Never.
The love keeps going and keeps recycling and keeps going. God never removes his love. Glory to God. And it comes in many different sizes and packages. And I'm grateful that I give you that joy.
Yes.
To remind you of this beautiful sister that I did not have the opportunity to meet. But the love is still there. The love keeps continuing and will never end.
And never end. Isn't that beautiful?
That's beautiful.
There is no God like you.
Amen.
Have you felt him tonight? Have you known
God
him tonight?
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
We want to pray for these six right here because they have a mission and we're part of their ministry. God made it so. He brought them here. He wove us together. And we're going to be a part. Whether you want us to or not, we're going to be a part. Praise our God.
Because we want you to.
We love you.
Yes, praise God.
We love you. We're too many miles behind. This is dedicated to you and to all the church and to the warriors here tonight. Dedicated to you, Brother Dale. It's dedicated to you, Joan. Praise God. To all the saints who have stood by the church. To those that have recently the Lord dealt careless dedicated to you. Praise God.
Yes, that's right.
Too many miles behind.
Too many miles behind me. Too many trials are too many.
verse is my verse, and it can be your verse. I've crossed the hot, burning desert.
Oh my.
Striving the right road to choose. And sometimes only the grace of God helped me finally to choose the right road. That may be your story too tonight. But however it is, thank God.
Amen.
You chose the right road. Because somewhere up ahead, there's clear water. You'll find it in Revelation 22.
Yes.
I saw a pure river of life. Clear as crystal. Proceeding out of the throne of God and of the Lamb. And defeat is one word. I believe. That's your song tonight. That's your song.
Yes,
praise God. Remember the night when it looked like there was no way out. Remember the day when your heart was so sad. You couldn't think, would there ever be a tomorrow? I doubt you've escaped that. I believe somewhere you've run into that time. I did, and I have. Sister Marlo has. We all have. Thank God. Somewhere up ahead. And now I'm going to change that. Not just ahead. It's here tonight. It's here right now.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
We've crossed the hot, burning desert, striving. Have come with a peculiar burden or a peculiar need or a need that perhaps no one else shared. I don't want you to leave tonight. I don't want you to go through that door, those doors, without knowing there's no God like you. years ago, I knew a judge, Judge Cook. He was an ex-judge at the time I knew him, but he was from Denver. This judge had found the bottom of life. I met him in a tent meeting in Missouri. And this judge said to me that night, he was in the crowd, and you wouldn't have looked at him as a judge because he had stubble on his face and his clothes were ragged. And he didn't look like a judge or ever been a judge. But he sat in the meeting. And by the way, Harry S. Truman was in that meeting, the President of the United States. But he was a judge himself in Kansas City at the time. This man finally came down to the altar. And he stood there, and I was with the preacher. I wasn't the evangelist. I was with him. And this man said, I am Judge Cook. At one time I had the power to let people go or put them in prison or give them the death sentence. But he said, I became so low, disgraced from my office, my home gone, everything gone. And I found myself listening to you people sing tonight. And he said, I decided to come here. The man that we didn't know and wouldn't know till after he was gone was Harry S. Truman. Had his fedora hat, the overcoat on, had his aides around him, and he came down back up where the judge was praying. And we asked him to give his life to Christ and commit his life to Jesus Christ and that he would be saved. Harry S. Truman stood back here and watched and observed. He said to someone, that's real, but I have too much to give up. You don't have too much to give up. No matter who you are, you don't have too much to give up. Jesus Christ is Lord of the life you live. Whether you're young, whether you're old, I'm telling you, nothing is of value without you keep him in the center of your life. Old time salvation is still in effect.
Yes.
I don't care how much the church has modernized itself, you cannot modernize the cross.
Right.
The cross is there for all mankind. For every illness, for every need. So we're going to say to you, if you want to come and be, and just say, I just want to surrender tonight. Anything I have left in my life, I want to give it. I'm going to find a new, by the way, Judge Cook regained his respectability. He didn't regain his judgeship, but he regained his place. Family, some of his family united with him. And his story was that of a man who found God. God is able. It doesn't matter who you are.
Amen. 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 Brother Mara, yes, Lord. There's somebody here tonight. You feel like you're exhausted, weary. You feel like you're about ready to give up. I want to share something quickly with you.
Listen.
My wife and I, we were in Nepal. We were in the country of Nepal, worst we've ever been in, poverty. My wife had respiratory problems, real bad, but we're still trying to go on with the work, and we rode an old bus for about 10 hours and then ride another vehicle about 7 hours to get to church, but on the way there, the only place we could get was a place, said it was a resort, but it was there they were a resort in the jungle. And that night, the natives had a wild drunk party outside our room. While I was there, I was able, it was just a miracle, I was able to get internet service. on my iPad, and Holly American Cruise Line, they had an emergency. And they needed a minister on a cruise in Chile. Usually we had to pay for the fare, but I said this would be all free, hotel, airfare, and everything. We were exhausted. I mean, we were completely exhausted, but we accepted it. Couldn't believe a miracle there. In 2 days, they flew us out of Nepal. We had to go by New Delhi, India, into Paris, France, and it was long, long hours. By the time we got to Chile and got on the ship, we were both just completely exhausted. She was still coughing and having problems with respiratory. At first service, I began to preach about Jesus in the wilderness.
Thank you, Jesus.
And how that in the garden,
thank you, Lord,
how he suffered so much agony.
Yes.
But you know,
yes,
in the wilderness, whenever the trial was over, angels came and ministered to him.
Yes. Lord.
In the garden, when he was agonizing for you and I,
yes,
angels came and ministered to him.
Thank you, Jesus.
Those angels came and ministered to Lita and I.
Thank you, Jesus.
They gave
Lord.
Us strength. They gave
thank
us strength.
You, Jesus.
So the Lord is saying tonight, don't give up. No matter what you're going through, no matter how tired or weary you are, the Lord can send those angels as it did with our Lord and Savior and minister to you. All you have to do is just come unto him and he will give you rest.
Praise the Lord.
A man of God has spoken. I believe the word he spoke. I believe the word he spoke.
Yes, I believe.
I believe that you're here. Here's one. He's very close to me, Sister Lori House and Brother House. And I know this woman has carried a load, and this man has carried a load. They are the champions of victory. God is going to lift this woman to the highest level. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Brother John, will you come and stand with her?
Yes.
Praise God.
Yes.
Because he has been under attack. And Gloria has been under attack.
Yes. Thank you,
but they are soul-winning people. They are soul-winning people. She writes books that are so inspiring to read. God is able now to strengthen her and refresh her. There's someone else in the crowd. You ought to come tonight. Make a break. Make a break. Don't hold back. Don't stand anymore. Stay
this
back.
Is your night. No. This is your night.
Don't be ashamed of Jesus. He's not ashamed of you. Leave the chair where you're standing and say, I'm coming. I don't know what will happen when I get right here, but I know my life will be changed forever. Praise the name of the Lord. He touched me, or whatever the Lord you want. Hallelujah. Just come wherever you are. Come wherever you are.
And touch the Lord. This moment. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Well, it's that time again this evening. You already heard all of the announcements. We know, you know, we have Bible study tomorrow night, bilingual Tuesday, Wednesday night service here, Thursday night down in Port Charlotte, and then Friday, who knows where we're going to all be, and then back here. Don't forget Pastor Jared Manning's going to be here tomorrow. I guarantee you, you'll be excited to sit and listen to that young man as he preaches.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, a miracle. God give her a miracle. Right?
Amen.
And touch her on the hip, Lord. In the name of Jesus.
Oh,
she prays for that miracle. We pray for that miracle. Receive it, Lord. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Yes, Jesus. Praise God. Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus.
Praise God. Amen. Amen.
At Tuesday at 12 o'clock, Brother Embry is going to have his Bible study. Then we also have the youth group Wednesday night at the start of our service. Our pastor's tired. He's been on that road trip. He looks exhausted. So we're going to try to give him some rest until tomorrow night. So if we all would, let's just stand up. And let's just love one another, greet one another, and we'll see you tomorrow night.